Just got real.
It was a sad situation.
here for. I want it. I'm not here for great shit. Disrupt their shit like they disrupt our fucking lives.
I ain't no real Justin, homie.
Thank you.
DJ!
Are you hiding?
Happy!
To the bank. Shit's intense right now.
You got some milk?
Oh shit, wait.
That's your gas.
Yeah, no. Why didn't they fucking up the cops phone?
Fucking that cop car up.
Come on, baby. Yeah.
Lady.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, let's go over there. Oh, sorry. Hey, move back. Keep your eyes open.
I You should have brought your camera. You can get some good shots.
What happened?
Do it again, man.
Like, shit, fuck you! I'm sorry!
Oh, Jesus.
Yes, look at the picture out of you.
Man, that cop hit me. I was like, oh, shit, I'm going down. Huh? Yeah, he, like, fucking elbowed the shit out of me. I was like, that's it, I'm going.
With the shield?
Huh? He hit me with a shield. When he like, was trying to get that dude, I was like, I didn't do nothing. I'm just recording and protesting.
Keep your phone up. Do not put your phone down like this. Okay? They will think it's a gun. Keep it up.
She gave us a lesson. Hey, look, we're getting really close to warehouse.
Oh, shit.
No, they won't do anything there.
Yeah, this is like...
It's a music venue. Warehouse Live is amazing. The people there are amazing. The people that work there are amazing. House of Blues, too. I was there for a very long time. They got some really good people there. Oh, here they come. Here they come. Oh, I see it. Caleb, you just can't. It's their music venues, dude. It's the thing that keeps the peace. Music keeps the peace. It's the next. Oh shit! Here we go. Part two.
Part two, baby.
Bitch ass, huh? I'm so hurt out here.
Yeah, you too.
Start, what do you call it, tear gassing and all that shit. So I brought some milk, so I've been carrying this for a couple hours now. They maced a couple of people earlier, so you know, I helped them out and I put like milk in their eyes and all that stuff, and it definitely helped them, which is, I mean, I've never experienced anything like this. There's definitely a lot of emotions and a lot of anger, obviously. So everyone started moving because I guess the cops started doing this tactic where they started circling people. Everybody that was in that little square of the intersection, so they all just started shielding it up, so everyone's like, get out of there. So that's what we did. Brandon, I hear you. I mean, it's draining, but at the same time, I mean, like, being here, you know, I kind of understand what's going on, you know, you're seeing it with your own eyes, not only here, but in other places. Like, you know, people are trying to make a statement. I mean, a lot of people are like, you know, oh, peaceful protesting and all this stuff, but, you know, I think our brothers and sisters are tired of it. So you make a point. I mean, even though it's very drastic, sometimes you just gotta make a point somehow. You know, the cool thing I saw about this entire thing is, like, nobody here destroyed anyone else's cars or just destroyed random vehicles. They didn't spray paint random vehicles or go damage other people's property. I think everything has been really targeted towards the cops.
They're circling us.
Yeah. Now the cops are heading this way, and they're doing like a circle technique where they're meeting everyone at the other end of the street where they were walking already. lot of people definitely got out a lot of their rage on the police cars. They're here, they're all here waiting. So everywhere we're moving at this point, at first it wasn't like this, they weren't following us. It was until the actual until the vandalism started happening, that's when they all showed up. Interesting, earlier on today, like, there was a girl on a wheelchair. I guess the cop didn't like what she had to say,